If you're a river crossing buff like me, you like to find sweet gems in areas you don't expect them to be. Here I am at Sinking Springs, Pennsylvania. A unique U.S. switch and single mast is still in operation with a Griswold cantilever, and on top of that, a Western Railroad Supply crossing bell. If you're a guy that likes listening to vintage railroad crossing bells, there aren't many examples around anymore on modern railroads, but Sinking Springs is a gem for a railroad crossing enthusiast. Sinking Springs is also a nice place for a mix of pedestrian gates. So, here are two Western Railroad Supply pedestrian gates, still looking nice in their old silver paint. You want even more railroad history? Well, here's a conrail, no trespassing sign that's nailed to a telegraph pole. As the sun went down, I waited for my first train. Then it finally arrived. It was 9:32, an empty Hertzhog train heading westbound. The power tonight was a Norfolk Southern ST60M number 6784, a formal conrail unit. And behind that was a Dash 840 CW, and I believe it was 8423. I couldn't see it. And it went by pretty quick. Final stop for tonight would be Richmond, Pennsylvania. Here is train 35Q, a manifest heading westbound. The lead power is 7608, which is ES40DC, and behind that, trailing, is a Dash 940 CW number 9427. Now something interesting about this train is, after the train had passed by, we heard on the radio that there were actually train hoppers on the train, and that the train would stop at milepost 107 and get the police involved. In the video, we'll spot both of the guys on the bulkheads. One of them was wearing a white shirt and the other one was wearing a blue shirt. Thank you. And that would be it for tonight's Railfanning. Thank you all for watching. This is Train Fanatic signing off.